This is the story of the Ewok adventure. You can read along with me in your book. You will know it is time to turn the page when you hear the chimes ring like this. Let's begin now. The tiny forest moon of Endor is home to a race of small, furry creatures known as Ewoks. The Ewoks live in simple tree huts and lead peaceful lives. One night, an Ewok family stumbled upon a crashed Star Cruiser deep in the forest. Deej, the father Ewok, sniffed carefully at the ship. Hearing a tiny cough, he peered inside and found a frightened, sick little girl. Deej held out his paw to her. As the Ewoks gently picked up the girl, a laser blast tore through the cabin.
Hey! Put my sister down, you overgrown teddy bears!
A young boy stood in the doorway, holding a laser gun. The little girl coughed.
It's all right, Maze. I think they want to help us. Besides, maybe they know where Mom and Dad are.
Well, okay. But I'm gonna watch these little furballs.
In a simple hut in their village, the Ewoks nursed the tiny girl back to health. Deej's youngest son, Wicket, was sitting by her side and holding her hand when Mace came up behind him.
Scram! Get out of here, mop face!
Wicket dashed over to hide behind his mother's legs.
You feel better, Sindel? I don't trust these weird fuzzy things. They can't even talk right.
Day by day, Sindel got better until one day she felt strong enough to play with Wicket and his pet animals. But Mace was still uncomfortable with the Ewoks.
Listen, sis, we should get out of here pretty soon. Mom and Dad might be waiting at the Star Cruiser.
Wicket giggled excitedly. Sindel gasped and turned to Mace.
Did you hear that? He spoke.
Big deal. We've got to get back to where we crashed.
Wicket cocked his head. Late that night, the two children sneaked out of the Ewok's hut and crept through the dark forest. They hadn't gone far when they heard a low growl behind them. Suddenly, a huge Bora crashed out of the woods, its fierce eyes blazing and its sharp fangs bare.
Run, Sindel! Head for that hollow tree!
The children ducked into the tree just as the creature swung a mighty claw at them. All night long, the Bora tore at the tree, but it couldn't reach the children. Then at dawn, there was a big commotion. Sindel peeked outside to see the Ewoks battling the beast. They drove it back with spears as it snapped at them fiercely. Finally, the brave Ewoks won the fight. Mace saw a charm hanging from the Bora's neck.
Look! It's Mom and Dad's life monitor, and the light's still on! They're alive! But where could they be?
Wanting to help the children, Deej took them to Logray, the medicine man. The old gray Ewok peered into a strange candlelit spinner. Sindel stared in wonder as an image started to take shape in the twirling windows.
Maze, it's Mommy and Daddy. They're trapped in a cave somewhere, and there's a giant monster there.
Maze turned frantically to Logray.
Where are they? Can you tell?
In answer, the image slowly changed to a set of dark cliffs. Logray pointed to a map to show Deej where the cliffs were. Sindel watched as Deej looked to his sons and then nodded.
Oh, Maze, they're going to help us find Mommy and Daddy.
The next day, Wicket's mother looked on sadly as her husband and sons prepared for their long journey. As they loaded up their horses, Logray paid them an unexpected visit. The medicine man solemnly handed a special item to each member of the party. To Deej's older sons, Logray gave warrior earwings. To Wicket, he gave a magic walking stick. And to Sindel, he gave an eternal candle. Then Logray handed Deej a tooth and a staff crown. Mace picked up the last item.
A rock? That's what I get? I don't need any stupid rock.
Mace tossed it over his shoulder. The caravan wound through the thick forest. Suddenly, a huge tree fell in the party's path. A tall, stocky Ewok named Chuka ambled from the woods, proudly carrying his hatchet. Mace faced the furry lumberjack.
Hey, you almost killed us.
Chuka tweaked Mace's nose playfully. Deej handed the lumberjack the special tooth from Logray. It fit right into a place on Chuka's necklace. The rugged Ewok nodded and joined the caravan. Later in the journey, the group came upon Kenk, an Ewok priestess. Deej explained their quest to Kenk and gave her the staff crown. As a test, the mystic handed the crown to Mace. Magically, it became an ugly lizard. Mace leaped back.
Hey, get rid of that thing!
But when Sindel picked it up, it turned into a delicate white mouse. Taking the staff crown back, Kenk smiled and put it on her staff. A perfect fit. Now there were 8 adventurers. Mace felt dejected.
Nobody takes me seriously. I wish Mom and Dad were here.
The young boy bent down to gaze at his reflection in a pond. Slowly, he extended his finger and touched the water's surface. Suddenly, the pond pulled Mace right in. The boy was trapped beneath the pond. Mace pounded on the surface with all his might, but he couldn't escape. Chuka tossed vines and branches into the enchanted pond, but the water just dissolved them. Finally, Wicket timidly poked his magic walking stick into the pond. He felt a tug. Sindel rushed to his side.
Come on, everybody! Pull!
Slowly, Mace came out of the pond. The boy smiled shyly at Wicket.
You saved my life. Thanks.
Wicket patted Mace's head.
Christ!
After the Ewoks had set up camp that night, Mace found a hole in the ground filled with thousands of tiny, twinkling creatures. They were Wisties. With a burst of laughter, they all sprayed up in a dazzling shower of brilliance, lighting up the whole camp. Sindel stepped out of her tent carrying her eternal candle. The Wisties danced wildly around the tiny flame. Laughing madly, they swirled right into the candle and disappeared. Mace glanced at the tall grass near the Ewok's camp and discovered a faint flickering.
Why, it's one of the light people. Hey, little one, you must have gotten lost.
The Wistie danced about Mace's head, laughing and giving off a soft light.
You should have a name. How about Isrina? Here, you can ride in my shirt pocket.
The next day, the caravan stopped on some rocky ground. There ahead stood the dark cliffs they had seen in Logray's image spinner. Sindel turned to her brother.
Whenever we get in a jam, one of Logray's gifts helps us. Where's your rock, Mace?
Mace sighed sadly.
I didn't keep it. I...
Wicket nudged the boy and placed the magic rock in his palm.
Thanks, little guy. I guess you bailed me out again.
Chuka broke open the rock, revealing an arrowhead which spun slowly and then shot off to show a secret opening in the cliff face. After telling Sindel and Wicket to stay behind, the party followed a rock stairway to a pit covered by thick strands of webbing. Carefully, the group crawled across the pit. Suddenly, a huge spider clambered onto the web. Mace's eyes widened.
Quick! We've got to cut the web!
Mace hacked at the strands, but the spider was charging too quickly. Kenk stepped forward, spinning her magic staff. Dazed, the spider stopped in its tracks. Chuka hacked through the last strand, and the spider fell into the deep pit. The adventurers crept down the damp tunnel and stopped at a huge doorway. Mace and the Ewoks gasped as a giant shadow passed over them. They were in the chamber of the giant Gorax. Mace peeked inside.
That's the monster that captured Mom and Dad. Come on!
They slid silently along the wall, watching as the frightening Gorax sat down to dinner. Mace pointed to a cage that hung in the chamber.
Look! There are my parents!
Bravely, Deej's son, Michi, raced across the chamber and danced in front of the Gorax. Mace watched as the giant angrily chased the Ewok out of the room.
We'd better hurry! He won't be able to keep that monster busy for long!
The Ewoks dashed across the chamber, rigged up a springboard, and set Mace soaring up into the cage. He hugged his parents tightly.
I'm so glad you're all right. Now we've got to hurry. Here, I brought some rope vines.
Mace and his parents slid down the vines. Suddenly, an angry bellow filled the chamber. The Gorak stumbled back in, still chasing Weegee. Everyone bolted for the door, everyone but Chuka. Bravely, he swung around and charged the monster, hatchet held high. The Goraks tried to snatch the furry Ewok up, but Chuka was too fast. The lumberjack packed the monster hard on the leg. Suddenly, a bright light sprang from Mace's pocket and buzzed around the giant's head.
Go get him, Isreena!
Swinging at the tiny glow, the Gorak smashed his fists into the wall, sending rocks flying. In horror, Mace saw the shower of stone crash down on Chuka. He dashed over to his fallen friend.
Chuka, get up, please!
But the wounded Ewok was dying. Chuka smiled weakly, handed the young boy his prized hatchet, and tweaked him on the nose one last time. The Gorax was about to grab Mace when Isreena made a dazzling dive at the monster. The Gorax swatted at her madly as she flew around his head. Finally, he dashed blindly out of the chamber. The Gorax thundered down the tunnel. Ahead, the Ewoks had stretched a vine tightly across the edge of the spider pit. With a howl, the creature tripped over the vine and sailed into the abyss. The Ewoks cheered wildly. Sindel appeared on the other side of the pit and waved to the group.
Mommy! Daddy!
Suddenly, a hairy claw rose out of the pit and reached for her. It was the Gorax.
I'll save you, sis!
Mace grabbed a strand from the spider web and swung across the pit. He hurled Chuka's hatchet right at the Gorax. The creature plummeted downward for the last time. A joyous celebration was in full swing in the tiny Ewok village. Each of the families was together again. Mace stepped outside, took Isreena out of his pocket, and softly said goodbye to the tiny glow. Sindel joined him, and Mace took his sister's hand.
You know, these furry little guys are pretty special. They split up their own family to help us find ours. You know, I'm glad we crashed here.
Wicket slipped his paw into Mace's hand.
Christ!
That was the end of the story.